Sign up today.
The following is a presentation of TFNN. The Tiger Technician Hour with your host, Basil Chapman. Call now, toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044. Now, Basil Chapman.
Hi, everyone. Basil Chapman here on this Thursday, the 14th of January. And we're looking at the Dow up 135 and 31,194. Made an all-time high today. Now, we're starting to see some separation. And this is going to be very interesting because by Monday to Tuesday, Monday afternoon to Tuesday morning, I think we're going to have a much clearer picture of what successfully is looking into the programs of the coming administration, what is being set aside for the moment, what has to be immediate. My suspicion is that a lot will be said. What will be done has to have a timetable, and social programs, I think, get first oppies. I think the money goes out as quickly as possible, as much as possible. I think that's what they're going to try for. That's the humanitarian side. But when I'm looking at, let me just run this down. So the Dow's up 136, absolutely key support by a week from today. If we're trading under 30,600, we're in for some kind of a consolidation. A move to the 31,000 into the 31,400 or higher area is really very positive. Looking at the S&P trading right now below its all-time high from 5 days ago of 3826.69, it's at 3816, 10 points below it. No big deal. It's up 6.65 on the day, making a little cup formation. Just hasn't had the strength. It might make a peak D in the Chapman Wave inside track repellent zone of the weekly chart. Only leg B in the monthly. And that says 2021 is going to see higher highs. Doesn't matter how far we fall, it should see higher highs. And I would say higher highs in the first half of the year, maybe even in the first quarter. So here we go. The the QQQ, no all-time high today. It's at 316.18, some $3 below the all-time high of 5 days ago, 319.39. A trade up into the 322 to 325 area in the coming week would be really positive, but a slide below 311 would say, oh, be careful, could have a consolidation peak D in the weekly chart. Next thing we're going to look at is the IWM. No stopping the IWM yet, the Russell 2000. One of the reasons why, like the Dow, we want to remain long the IWM. In fact, we're waiting for a chance to increase the holding in that. But the MACD is strong. Stochastic's at 93% in the daily, 95% in the weekly. And listen to this. 89% in the monthly. These are fantastic numbers. To get this to change, you would have to have such bad news that the IWM, trading at 214.30 right now, up 4.56, just a tad below, a few ticks below its all-time high, of intraday, that is. This is essentially saying, and just do a quick visual. You know what I like to do, the Chapman Wave falling axe formation, when there's a move to the upside above the falling axe, lower highs and much lower lows, and you get an expansion of that. Let me just do this right now for you. This would be the projection. The projection has to go to there. So far, it's in a parallel move. I don't think on a monthly basis it can stay like that. That'll just be vertical. It's impossible to think along those lines. This is, I make this blue as I always do, just make it blue so you can see it. And you get your very conservative number, 1-to-1 right now, make that pink. This is a monthly chart. It's hard to believe that we're talking monthly chart here. Look, the monthly chart says from most conservative low that I would take is right here, that little trough right there, if you're looking at my monthly chart. And that takes you to where? That takes you, okay. There we go. Move it up right there. Takes you to about 216, right? That's the conservative one. If that breaks above it, only then can we go to the next expansion. That would take you considerably higher into the 228, 232 area. I don't like doing that. I just go one step at a time. I'm looking monthly. You've got to see how the weekly, the daily, which is only in a leg B, I'm calling this a leg B, is. I could give it an alternate count, but it still comes out to very positive. I suspect that this is telling me that if there is some kind of a sharp pullback, that the IWM will still maintain its leadership role a little longer before it has it joins the crowd. Now, what's really important about this is that you've only just now started to flatten out in the stochastic. And that says that the stochastic to go from 93% to, say, 87%, sorry, 78%, which is where it would become negative, we'd have to see the price fall below the 14-period moving average. The IWM daily is 204.23. It's called 204. I mean, something terrible has to happen. So far, that's not the case. I want you to show you something else. The SMHs are making new all-time highs, and I'm calling this. I needed to check. Never chance before. 236.75 to 236.65. So this is now either yet another instant restart. These ChapmanWave instant restarts. When I discovered this in some lodge, ski lodge, when my son was skiing, and I was sitting in the lodge with my charts way back, hand charting with pencil and ruler. People were looking to say, what is that guy do? What is that guy do? He's not even having coffee. So anyway, I discovered this ChapmanWave. This is called the ChapmanWave. Here we go. Instant restart. And if this is F/B, it says you could still go C and D, but I'm calling it an F for now because we've already had a huge move up. To get an instant restart at this level would just be beyond belief. But a lot of beyond belief things have happened. So the semiconductors, look at this massive leg. This is a single leg from the low. This is an index. This is a sector. This is not a stock. This is a sector for the whole sector to go from a low of March of 2020 at 96, round number low, in a single move up with two tiny little embarrassingly red candles, little tiny doji candles, with higher highs every single month and almost every single month, except for one, a higher low, it's impossible to think that this can continue into February. I think February is going to be a really interesting month. We'll see what happens. I thought January, end of January would be so far. It doesn't look like the case, but certainly February could be. And this is still basically one leg up from 96 to the high today of 242. I would say that 96 to 244 is a pretty good increase. All right. So here we go. We're going to be looking at gold. GC gold is down. It's down 7 points at 1846. No big deal. Still within this little range. But if this becomes the fulcrum for a move to the downside, and I'm beginning more and more to think that gold's appeal right now is starting to be lessened. Because why? Because you've got your Bitcoin, which is up 3,433. It's up 3,430. Do you realize that it was trading almost at that level, 4,910, back in December of 2018? And even on this last big move, it was in the 5,000s. Today, just a little gain is up. At 39,840, it hasn't gotten to its all-time high, which was made 5 days ago on the 8th at 42,770. I'll be back in a minute.
If you're not currently using the TAS profile scanner when looking at setting up your trading opportunities, then your arsenal is short a mighty weapon. The TAS Profile Scanner is a standalone piece of software that instantly filters over 2,500 global financial markets such as stocks, ETFs, commodity futures, and Forex. Headed by Steve Dahl, TAS understands that in today's technological world, the use of top-flight software applications and technical analysis expertise is essential to successful trading in today's market. You also gain access to the webinar that Steve Dahl and Tom O'Brien just hosted, The Best Way to Use the TAS Profile Scanner to Profit. This webinar archive is available for all subscribers immediately upon signing up. All new subscriptions also come with a 30-day money-back guarantee, so you have nothing to risk. Start your subscription by visiting the front page of TFNN.com today, and you'll find the TAS Profile Scanner under the Services tab. Sign up today.
Are you in the market for buying or selling real estate in the Bay Area, including the surrounding St. Petersburg, Tampa, and Clearwater markets? Tiger Real Estate LLC is a firm that has extensive experience in the Tampa Bay Area. Whether you're looking to sell your current property for maximum value, or you're in the market for a second home or investment property, Tiger Realty has the experience across all areas of real estate in the Tampa Bay area to help buyers and sellers make the most informed decisions across all price levels. From the price you should be paying per square foot in certain up-and-coming areas to the type of cash flow investment properties are capable of creating, Tiger Real Estate can help you make the best decision when it comes to all areas of the market. Before you make one of the biggest decisions of your financial future, call Tiger Real Estate LLC today at 727-329-8322 or email us at tiger@tfnn.com. That's 727-329-8322. Call us today.
Hey there, I'm Andy Arbertine with Tiger Precious Metals and Stones. Whether you're looking to buy and sell precious metals or trying to find the perfect diamond ring, I'm here to help. I have over 15 years of experience with diamonds and precious metals. You can call me directly at 727-329-8245, and I will personally answer any questions you have and help you find exactly what you're looking for. I will be your personal concierge in the metal and stone business. Give me a call today, 727-329-8245.
Many of our new listeners have heard about The Tiger's Den. The Tiger's Den is a lively community where professional traders and investors can meet, exchange ideas and information in a comfortable, moderated atmosphere. Hear all of the TFNN shows, plus see all of the charts as they happen live and have access to archives of all of those charts. You can test drive The Tiger's Den absolutely free for 30 days and greatly enrich your knowledge of these markets and how to make your money work for you. Details on The Tiger's Den are on the front page of TFNN.com. Call now, toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-873-7618.
Yes, so I can't remember if we were doing this live at the time. This is Bitcoin. Had a question about it. Bitcoin, I think, is starting a consolidation phase. Does it break above the high of peak F? I'm calling it an F for now. I could have an alternate count because there was certainly a fantastic little ChapmanWave insight. There we are. All right. There could be a restart right there. And what's even more important is that it's an F/C in the weekly chart, Bitcoin, and it's a C, only a C in the monthly. So it still go to at least a D. So it's still bullish. But I think we're starting. In fact, I'll draw this out. I think we could go to 42,000, just a little higher. But my guess is that we're going to start a really big trading range because now it's official. You've got the real heavies are now in this. And that makes it less volatile, not in percentage terms, but less volatile in the sense that the major support now has been raised to at least the 24 to 20 area. So any, that's cut in half and by more, it's even more than cut in half, but that's a little bit above the last major high, which was in the, what was it, Bitcoin, last major was 5,000 something. Well, let's even go to the one that was just in September of last year, which was in the 10,000, 11,000 area. Okay, so that's that. I wanted to get back to silver. I had a question about it. Yeah, silver. Did I type that? There it is. Silver is like gold, it's consolidating. It is actually up 10 cents at 25.65, holding way better. I still think that silver is holding better, but I'm going to be discussing, I won't do it today, maybe tomorrow, maybe Monday. I'm going to discuss an aspect that I think is very important in terms of gold, which could relate differently to silver. And then I just wanted to show high-grade copper. It's holding really well up in the high level consolidation so far. Put together with wood, the iShares of the global timber and forestry ETF, which finally did get to a peak D in the daily, E in the weekly. I'm going to be watching this very closely because this is worldwide timber and lumber. Oh, where's our man, the Den, MCH from, was he from France? He used to always either correct me or confirm or whatever it is about the lumber. Well, we missed you. I haven't seen you for a little while. So we've got a peak D, and this says you could get a little consolidation here as well. So, yes, in many ways, there's a kind of a flurry and a fluster going on in the market, but it's specific areas and specific stocks. And if you look at, I had a question, I'll do it really quickly here, about MJ, which is the, oh my goodness, look at that. Up at 19.95, this is the MJ Alternate Harvest ETF, the cannabis sector. I've got this as only a leg B in the daily, leg D in the weekly. It's spiraled above the cup formation. Just for disclosure purposes, we are long from the 16s, it's trading the 19s right now. This is good. I wasn't sure. I didn't know enough, but even the chart formation said it was better for us to, in this particular instance, to go for the sector ETF, the MJ, Alternate Harvest Sector, Cannabis Sector, rather than to go for specific stocks, because it looked like it could break powerfully above this Chapman Wave Insight Track propellant zone, and it has so far. And there's the green. I drew this, it isn't quite right, it should be something like that, but this is the one-to-one extension of the propeller shaft that we were looking at. So far, very good. Next question. If I could do the TLT before I forget. TLT is down 54 cents at 152.11. This is going to be really important for everyone, including the new administration. Why? Because if the yields, you know what, last night I was working, and I was saying to myself, isn't this nice? It's been ages since I had a failure, a power outage, because when that happens, TradeStation, for some reason, I don't know why, but it doesn't immediately capture and hold everything I have and save it. I lose all that information. And then when I come back again, it goes to another part of the library. I can never find, I can't find it. So I had to do all my charts over from the 8th of last week. I don't know why I didn't even save over the weekend. Even Monday should have saved. And all of a sudden, and Tuesday. And all of a sudden, yesterday, as I'm saying, the thought went through my mind. Isn't this wonderful? I haven't had redo anything for ages. And as I finish ages, the darn thing freezes up, and I had absolutely no choice but to shut down as if it was a power outage. And, of course, everything goes. So I'm busy redoing. So TNX, this is another A, B, C, D to the upside. A, B, C, and that's your D right there. It's going to be very important because if yields trading at 1.099, 10.99 right now, break into the 12s, I think that's going to have an impact on the market. And if it's put together with the fact that money is going to be just thrown out the window right now, because every administration that's come in has seemed to, that's the way you survive, I guess, and they're about to do that. I don't know what's going to happen here. That's right. That's the Robin Hood of China. I'm going to be having a whole thing next week. I'm going to be talking about the match of Robin Hood. I've been talking about this for at least a couple of years now. But Robin Hood, together with the dark pools, well, they're really called pools back in the 1920s, where the little guy couldn't get in because the prices were so high. You know, like now we're looking at stocks in the 1,000, 2,000, 3,000 range. In those days, you were up at the 500, 600, even 1,000. I mean, can you imagine 1920 a stock in 1,000? That's unbelievable. So people were put into pools of like 4 or 5 stocks that were like a little ETF, and you could buy it, but you were buying fractions of shares. When I talk about the coda phase, we're getting to that coda phase. All right. So this is the TNX we're talking about, but most importantly, let's just quickly cover crude oil, which is making a peak here. I think one little pop to the upside, and then it could take a breather. I think they're going to take a breather. Now, I need to do this real quickly. I had a question. I want to get to it right now. It was a really good question from one of a Tiger, someone who's done my courses, hasn't for a little while, but had done a lot of my courses all the way through to level 2. And the question was on plug power. So I had to redo this. I had everything, of course, done. So I had to quickly do it as I got the message. So I've got this as an F/B. PLUG is the symbol. It's trading down 2.5 at 66.84. It made a high. God, I thought I did that. Oh, well, I have to do it over. It made a high yesterday of 73.90. 73.90 on the 13th. So 73.90, and just type that in. I think it's getting close to some kind of a pullback. 90. And it's a leg F/B with a doji candle. If it pulls back below 60 without making a new high, I think it's made a short-term top, but the technicals are still really good. And if it breaks into the 74.80 area, that's very good. It can hold this area for a little longer, but it is D in the weekly chart and it's E in the monthly. Reason why I want to put this together, so I have injury or pullback to 50.52 or wait until 39. All right, let's do one thing at a time. So we've got that question. And the next thing is BLDP. The reason why I always chuckle when I do this, if I remember, I'll tell you when I get back. And it's a story about the sixes and the fours. And then the twos. And then goodbye. And now it's at 38. It's a 38 round number high yesterday, straight into 34 now. Basil Chapman, Dow's up 115, S&P's up 6. We'll be right back with the story of Valid Power Systems.
With markets trading with extreme volatility and peaks and troughs everywhere, regardless of what you're looking at in the markets, this is a great time to see the type of analysis Basil Chapman delivers for his subscribers every market day with the Opening Call newsletter. Basil has been analyzing markets, providing his take for subscribers to his trading services since 1984. Every morning, Basil publishes an update for his subscribers, along with weekend and evening updates when warranted. The Opening Call provides traders a daily market overview with regard to the direction of the key indices, selective stocks and commodities, along with specific recommendations, including stops and targets. You also gain instant access to Basil's subscriber webinar archive from earlier this year, a dark cloud cover and essential market analysis. Ride the Chapman Wave today by signing up for the Opening Call newsletter on the front page of TFNN.com under the newsletter tab. New subscribers get a 30-day money-back guarantee, so you have nothing to risk. Sign up today. If you're a trader in the market looking to find the path that leads to maximizing profits while decreasing risk, then now is a great time to try out Dave White's daily trading service, The Path of Least Resistance. Through the use of options and equity trades, Dave advises his subscribers on a daily basis of the current market conditions and what possible trade setups are on the horizon. The Path of Least Resistance is published every trading morning, often with updates intraday when initiating trades or closing out positions. Dave White has advised his clients of some outstanding winning options and equity trades in recent months, and now is a great time to try it out for yourself. New subscribers to the Path of Least Resistance receive a 30-day money-back guarantee. See for yourself the types of options and equity trades that are available by signing up for the Path of Least Resistance today by visiting the front page of TFNN.com and selecting the newsletter tab. Sign up today. TFNN is excited about our new software charting program, The Art of Timing the Trade Charts. In collaboration with Tom O'Brien and using his best-selling book, The Art of Timing the Trade, Your Ultimate Trading Mastery System, David White has programmed an outstanding piece of software that will complement any trader's methodology. Using this first-of-its-kind program, The Art of Timing the Trade Charts allows you to scan thousands of stocks for Fibonacci formation setups, including Gartley's, ABC's, Butterflies, and much more. The Art of Timing the Trade Charts is designed to help you when scouring the markets for stocks just beginning to form the trading patterns that many investors spend days, weeks, or even months searching to find. And right now, we're offering licenses available at only $79 a month. We are so confident that you're going to love this new charting software that will even give you a 30-day unconditional money-back guarantee. Don't miss out on this incredible new piece of software. Get your copy of The Art of Timing the Trade Charts today by visiting TFNN.com.
This segment is brought to you by Think or Swim. For more information, just click the Think or Swim banner on the front page of TFNN.com.
Yes. So, all right, Valid Power, real quickly, because there's just so much to do. I don't want to waste time on stories that mean nothing to anybody. But this is an interesting one in the sense that it's human nature. So I have a friend way, way back who comes to me, just calls up one day and says to me, what do you think of buying those battery stocks? This is when down in Watertown, there was this company. Was that Ballard? That wasn't Ballard Power. Anyway, there was this battery company at the Arsenal Mall area. And so he said to me, what about buying a battery company and all that? So he says, I'm looking, so I see, well, these are the names that you want to look at. I mean, you know, just make a choice because this is a long-term, a very long-term proposition. He says, no, I believe in electric power. His son had just bought a Prius, I think. So this is maybe 12, 13 years, I don't know how many years ago. Anyway, so he buys Ballard Power and another one in the area. And it just sits there, and it goes from, like, I think he bought it at 6 or something, goes to 8, and it comes down. He bought it at 8, went to 6. Eventually, he's just had enough. It's in the 2s and 3s. He says, I am done. I am selling, and should I sell my wife's portfolio? This is just ridiculous. I say, got to stay in. Long term, just stay in. Okay. So he said, but do whatever you want with it, but I just keep it there. You don't need the money. It just sits, let it just sit there. No, I'm done. All right, so he's out, and he's out at about 3, takes a loss, etc. It's trading now at 34. Well, I don't know what he did with that money over the period of time. Let's call it 10 years. It's probably a little more. Maybe it's 10 years. Maybe he made more than that. You never know, right, what happens to money. But look at it. It's trading at 34. So, you know, sometimes the long term is fantastic. It could be the other way around. Could have been, you know, you buy one of those stocks that just keeps going down. So I just wanted to mention that this is Ballard Power Systems in the battery. This is in the area. I think that this is an area. I'm going to do the same thing here, but I'm doing it on the weekly. I think we're coming in. We are very close to having a digestive phase. And this can see the stock trading at 34, hitting a 38 round number high yesterday in leg E on balance volume. You gave me a sell signal just on the on balance volume, nothing else. Everything else is looking very good. Remember, I like things to go in stepwise motion. I think that we're going to be looking at a big consolidation coming up in this particular area because there is a lot of competition. And also, you do have crude oil working its way higher. I think crude oil is the one in the long term that's going to suffer the most damage. And that's why I'm really impressed that a country like a city like Dubai can do what they've done, the Arab Emirates, to be able to, in that area, to be able to change from purely oil-based economy to a multinational economy. To do that is far-sighted and very, very impressive. Okay, enough with that. We're done with this. So I'm just going to say to you, so your plug on the other one, you've got your notations. But on this one, let's see, buy 29.5 or wait for 23. You know what? Let's wait for it to pull back because if it gaps down below the gap that was made underneath on the 12th of 31.12, and the high the previous day of 29.42, if it goes right down below it, then you're looking at a potential for the second gap down. No, it's actually the third gap down to be filled. So, Jim, a re-entry or an entry, have patience. I even now you could buy it for a quick pop, but I wouldn't touch it. You're in it, that's great. If you aren't in it, don't be a wise guy. Think it through and say the monthly chart. You see, if I didn't have leg F, if this is a recycle and this is now only B, and I have no clue yet whether this is a B or an F, I would say to you, either way, have patience to wait. I believe if you put in a bid, your first bid in the 28 below 29, somewhere in the 28.50 area, when it gets there, you're going to have to make a decision. Oh my God, was that what I wanted? Or a great. Because if it balances and then comes back just a little more, that should be the last decline in this particular pattern. A to B equals C to D, that's the lightning bolt pattern. There's a dreaded H failure pattern. But if it just goes straight down from here, you got to be careful. So hold off, yes. What would be an entry on BLD? If you've never had it, if you've got some profits, you can afford to go in the 29s or the 28s. If you've never had any, you've never had this before, just have patience. You want to get it in a selling climax to the downside, not a buying climax to the upside. And if you look at volume, you know how I treat the Baba. Oh, I wanted to buy Baba. Dawn, remember I said that was a volume, ChapmanWave volume price climax low? And, oh, I wouldn't have got it because it gapped up. All right. I think that this is 28 days to the upside in Baba, Alibaba. This is the opposite I was talking about. So I think in a sense is a little bit of a climax to the upside. So give me, just have patience. Or you can just say, you know what? I don't have patience and I do have X amount of money devoted to this particular area. Let's see which one I want. Do I want plug? They're kind of different, you know, plug power, battery technology, but it's a different kind of technology to a ballot power. I don't quite know the difference, but I do know there's a difference. So I'm just going to say to you, both of them are looking good. Let's early next week, Tuesday or so, let's look at them again, and I'll have a better sense of exactly the numbers that I'd be looking at. But you're very close. You're not wrong. I'm just saying it's the way it gets there that's important. Next question was, I missed something yesterday. I meant to write it down. I wrote it down, I'm not going to deal with this every day, but another question came in. I had a screamer on our list today. I'll go through it exactly because we did not get it. It's a pity. We should have got it. There's no excuse. I should have got it. Now, let me just find it right here. So here's a stock that I looked at in my list yesterday. This is not the one I'm looking at. This is what I'm looking at. There you are. Okay. So I'm looking at my list of potential screamers for the upside, and the list kind of changes day to day. Not the point. The point is, up comes a stock. I thought, oh, ITT, I know that stock very well. Why is it so low? No, that wasn't ITT. It was ITI. So it was trading at 7, closed at 7. And it's called Iteris. I don't know how you pronounce it. Iteris, I-T-E-R-I-S, Inc. Software consulting. It actually does smart mobility, etc. And I love the chart pattern. As I pulled it up, it was a naked chart because it was the first time I'd ever seen it. And I wrote this whole thing up and I said, I gave reasons why I liked it. All right, that's what I always do. I did a little story there. Or if you didn't even have time to read it, all you have to do is go to my Trader's Corner and I'll tell you exactly what to do. What did I say to do in the Trader's Corner? I said, if I can find it right here, today's Thursday, right? Thursday. So I said, ITI, it was trading at 7.20. It already popped at 20 cents when I was doing this earlier this morning. It was very early this morning, about 5.30. But by the time I wrote it, I said, start along under $6.83 before 10:45 a.m. Eastern Time with a minus 20 stop. If long at $7.18, stop is 0.04 over the entry price. At 7.83, take half off, stop in the rest at 6.92. Look at the daily chart, big B, C chart, comments. So what does it do? I, as we go to the break, it hit the high today of...
Hi, folks, this is Tom O'Brien. The printing presses are working 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. The U.S. deficit has risen 200% in 1 year with no end in sight. The markets are looking for an additional stimulus bill to get us through this once-in-a-generation pandemic. There is no free lunch, folks. The more stimulus dollars put into the marketplace, the less your dollar is worth each and every day. This is the time to protect yourself with a portion of your portfolio in the metal market. The Gold Report comes out each Monday morning. I bisect and dissect the dollar, silver, gold, the XAU, and the HUI. The Gold Report is a long-term hedge against the dilution of your buying power. The U.S. has put more than $6 trillion into the marketplace in the last 6 months, with more expected in the next few months. The market did and does need the stimulus, but it will have long-term implications on our buying power. The Gold Report comes with a 30-day money-back guarantee. Go to TFNN.com and order the Gold Report now. Protect your buying power. Order the Gold Report now.
Are China A-shares hot or not? If you trade China A-shares, now may be time to take a closer look. Trade CHAU or CHAD, Direction's daily CSI 300 China A-Share Bull and Bear ETFs. China A-Shares in either direction. Visit directioninvestments.com today. An investor should consider the investment objectives, risks, charges, and expenses of the Direction shares carefully before investing. The prospectus and summary prospectus contain this and other information about Direction shares. To obtain a prospectus or summary prospectus, please contact Direction shares at 866-476-7523. The prospectus or summary prospectus should be read carefully before investing. An investment in the funds is subject to risk, including the possible loss of principal. The funds are designed to be utilized only by sophisticated investors such as traders and active investors. Distributor Foreside Fund Services, LLC.
Hey there, I'm Andy Arbertine with Tiger Precious Metals and Stones. Whether you're looking to buy and sell precious metals or trying to find the perfect diamond ring, I'm here to help. I have over 15 years of experience with diamonds and precious metals. You can call me directly at 727-329-8245, and I will personally answer any questions you have and help you find exactly what you're looking for. I will be your personal concierge in the metal and stone business. Give me a call today, 727-329-8245.
TFNN has launched our brand new website. You can still visit us at the same TFNN.com URL, but when you do, you'll see a new and improved homepage with a much simpler navigation, whether you're watching Tiger TV live in high definition or just accessing your newsletter subscriptions. We even have new pricing in 6 months and yearly options. Check out the new TFNN.com now and experience all the upgrades. TFNN.com, educating investors.
Don't forget, you can listen to TFNN live on your mobile device 24 hours per day. Go to TFNN.com, then hit Watch Tiger TV. That's TFNN.com, then hit Watch Tiger TV for the latest market information.
Hi, folks. Just wanted to show you how important peak D is in the Chapman Wave. Yes, look, there's a peak D in the two-minute E-mini chart. Pulls back sharply. It was like at 9:30 when the market went up in the prices of like the down the S&P, but down in the futures. And then it had a rally, went to another peak D, makes this beautiful arch, left side, right side price time match right to the middle there. It just missed it by a couple of pennies and then by a couple of minutes to the actual price target itself to hit that left side low, and now it's gone even lower. I am a little concerned here. I think that there's too much hype going on. Too many people think that everything gets resolved by any speech. No, there's a lot of work to be done, and it might be that it's in February, March, maybe even April, that more specifics come out, because this is, you know, the American economy is a super tanker. It doesn't just turn on a dime. So there are a lot of things that have to be looked at. Let's see, Basil, how do you treat the second low or double bottom to the exact price? Restart the count or count peaks between the two lows? Okay, so a real quick answer is that in my CD, I talk about the bottom. If you touch the same price, you actually restart the count. But very soon after that, I say, you know what? I've had so much experience now with it. As long as you don't go one penny below the left side low, you keep counting each higher high. Not only that, the only couple of little changes that I've made in my CD, the Introducing the Chapman-Wave Methodology, is that every peak counts. So that, I don't know if I can do it. I'll find one to show you. There was a fantastic example. I wrote it down, and now am I going to find it? Do I have time? Oh, it's on this page here. Did I circle it? I circled it. Oh, man. It was just exactly what you're talking about. I should do it while I'm thinking about it. Three times long. Oh. And, of course, I can't read the symbol. FANG. Let me just see if this is right. The FANG stocks, F-A-N-G. Is that the one? No, I can't remember why. So it made a peak D, P-A-B-C-D. And now it's gone to an E and an F. It's recycled. No, this is not the one. I'll find Diamondback Energy. This is an energy stock, FANG. Let's see. That's a good question. I'll try to write it down and get to it. People talking about – I've read this. All of us have read this over the years. Some people have forgotten their Bitcoin passwords. It's done. I don't know how you actually get it. How do you do it? What kind of proof? There's some big problems with Bitcoin. Can you imagine paying for something with Bitcoin at 5,000 and today that very same thing, cup of coffee, you're paying it with a coin that is at 30-something thousand, maybe 40,000? This will take a long time before Bitcoin is actually a currency. It'll be a form of currency, but not like the dollar. No. I was going to do something here. I answered that question. Good grief. I needed to do that. I needed to do that. I did everything. I did all the indexes. Had a question. Was just sitting there. Oh, that's right. Remember GDX yesterday? I said I'll just cover that a little bit more today to see what happens. Well, now it's moved. Just time alone. You remember, if you do work with channels, which I've done, you know, going back decades and decades, as it moves sideways, it's going to break a trend line. Just time alone does it. So I've always said, you've got to be looking at other things, not just a trend line when you're talking about trend lines. So just moving sideways says that this particular trend line right here, the lower trend line in the GDX, you're going to take it out. It's this pink line here. You want to see if there's a price move below 35 in the next couple of days. I think gold is going to go quite a bit lower. Right now it's holding very well. And to go with that is, look, the dollars, I hear everybody saying, oh, yeah, the dollar, all of a sudden I'm hearing the dollar. No, the dollar is in a bear market, a major bear market. I think that for a dollar to actually get really get going, you're going to have this administration consider that the dollar needs to be strong, not weak. You need money that only governments can do to really get the dollar to start and hold in the 92.80, 93.50, then 94.15, then 94.55, and then finally the 200 period moving average of 95.70. To do that, you can't just, it's not you, me, Goldman Sachs. It is the really big governments that put the kind of money that says the trend is changing because we have decided. The Fed must have decided that the dollar has to be weak from when it hit 102.99. So, yes, I'd love to see a bounce. We're still holding that long dollar from 2018 area in April at 90.07. It went all the way to almost 103, then pulled back to the 80, 89s. It's for other reasons that I'm trying to hold it as long as possible. That's right. The question came in. So I said, what do you do with the stock? I almost forgot about this, ITI. So what happened is it opened this morning. It didn't do what I wanted. It did it a little bit because the close yesterday was at $7. Yep, $7. So today it opened and it went opened at 698. And 697 was the low. So I want you to have a little bit more of a dip, then grab it, and then start peeling off. And then if it closed very nicely, and we still had something less, which has happened to some of our stocks like this, what I call the screamers, single-digit stocks, screamers. What a percentage move going from if we got it at the 680. Well, even if you got it at the low today of 697 to 781 in minutes. That's the kind of gain you want to keep doing a few of those periodically, and it builds up a kitty that says, I've now got the wherewithal that if I make a mistake, I've got the comfortability to say I've built up a little nest egg that says I don't have to throw that money away. It's for when I make those dumb mistakes, and we all make dumb mistakes. Sometimes you do something really clever, but the market says, you know what? That's a dumb mistake. Watch this, and it does something completely different. You got to be ready for that. A lot of talk about the Bitcoins. All I'm going to say is we're going to try to keep our Bitcoin. At some point, there could be another thing that says, oh, my God, if you've got Bitcoin, something, and Bitcoin drops, like it goes up 30%, it drops 30 to 50% back, just like that. We're ready because we've been peeling off on our Bitcoin all the way up to about 280% gain. But it doesn't matter. Those gains can disappear if you're careless. I'd rather say, wow, it would be fabulous if we were doubling up and tripling up. I mean, wouldn't that be incredible, having tripled from $12 GBTC, from the $12.40 entry point, and now you've each time it's pulled back at 1930, you just doubled up, and it screams to 48. It pulls back to 36, and you double up. Yeah, that's the way to make real good fortunes. It's also the way to have zero or even minus of a fortune. We can't do that. Very few people have the wherewithal to say, okay, I'll have to go. I've got something to sell. I can restart. Most of the time when you overplay your hand, you suffer a penalty, and that penalty is that it aggravates every single other trade you make after that. Even if you don't think it does, it does. So just try to avoid those mistakes. All right, we've got one break coming up. I have something to discuss. Pink says, Basil DTT makes new high and then sharp pullback for trough support in the 17s. And G7 said, DTT. Yeah, all of them are beginning to move. All right, we'll talk about DTT. I want you to avoid it today. I've spoken about it so often. We'll talk about it. I'll be back.
Back in the day, I joined Hotel California in 2006, and like many of you, was drawn in by, as well as,
whatever you think about, you bring about, whatever you focus on grows.
You see, I believe that everything in life happens for us, not to us, and Tom ignited the fire within me to want to learn how to master the markets. So how did I go from knowing nothing about technical analysis to becoming the number one market timer for the S&P 500 in 2018 and the number two market timer in 2019? Simply put, I hired coaches with a proven track record, which led me to a whole new set of tools that I created to interpret the message of buyers and sellers. I would love the opportunity to teach you this award-winning set of tools and help you improve your market timing. You can test drive my newsletter service, Mastering Probabilities, for the next 30 days with no risk to you. Plus, you'll gain access to archive workshops that'll take you step-by-step through my system. Sign up today by going to the homepage of TFNN.com and selecting Mastering Probability in the newsletter tab. Bam!
If you haven't checked out the newsletters page of TFNN.com, what are you waiting for? All of the TFNN newsletters are informative, up-to-date, affordable, and a must-have for every trader looking to gain a competitive informational edge in today's markets. TFNN newsletters cover every aspect of the markets to offer you the very latest in market news. Plus, new subscribers get to test drive our newsletters risk-free for 30 days. From all aspects of the markets, including stocks, bonds, metals, commodities, and tech, there's a newsletter to fit your needs exclusively from TFNN. Stay informed each day you trade and get that competitive edge that will help you stay ahead of the game. Visit our newsletters page by going to TFNN.com and click the newsletters button near the top of the page. TFNN.com, educating investors.
Introducing Primal Edge.
Today, it's even more important to take a supplement that complements your health. Primal Edge is specifically formulated to boost your immune system and help with weight loss, better sleep, stress reduction, and the need to detox.
Our early ancestors found all their nutritional requirements in the wild environment. But today, our food sources don't contain the vitamins, minerals, and nutrients that we need to stay healthy and strong.
That's why we need Primal Edge Daily Nutrition. It includes a special blend of ionic, soil-based vitamins, minerals, fatty and amino acids in an easy-to-use liquid form.
Primal Edge is powered by highly concentrated humic and fulvic acids, nature's preferred delivery system. They've been called miracle molecules because, like sunlight, air, and water, without them, life cannot exist.
That's right, Ellen. They ensure we receive all the nutrition we need to be healthy and thrive.
We take it every morning.
Primal Edge, just $89, exclusively at TFNN.com.
Hi, folks. This is Steve Rhodes. Stay tuned for another great hour of the Trader's Edge, heard here at TFNN.com.
Just a quick question. RRC, I was asked if I was posted at Royal Range Resources. Yes, this is in that area that I think is going to be really important. This is in the resources area. It looks really good. It's pulling back from today. I do believe ABCD. I think this is a brand new start of a move. Yeah, ABC. This is Lexi. It still looks good. I think it's going to go to just over 10, and then it might consolidate between 10 and a half, maybe touch 11. I think more than like 10, just over, just in the 10s, and then it comes back and it consolidates into the 8s over a period of time. That whole area, it seems to me, is very good. Looking out, that's an area that you want to be looking toward buying in the whole resources area, some of the different types of oil, maybe oil and gas mix, that type of thing. So the question came in here about – I'll just answer the question briefly. I'll do it in my newsletter, the opening call. I don't want to do it now because we spent too much time on it. It's up 19% DDD 3D systems at 27.92. I think this is more like the rectangle formation. Let's do a little bit more on it in my newsletter. Just people don't want to keep hearing about stocks that we have. So the other thing is, yes, I don't know how this can keep going. I'm just looking at the portfolio today. stocks up 19%, 10%, 9%, 1% down 11. That's down 2 cents, so it makes it 11 cents very low price. But we also have an option that isn't working right now, so that is down. So not everything works. I just want to make sure this can't go on. Something's going to change very soon. I think we're getting kind of overbought in the sentiment area and in many stocks. So we've just got to start being quite careful here. Just to sum up, because you're going to go over to Steve Rhodes, you've got Steve Rhodes, Dave White, Tom O'Brien coming up. Great shows this afternoon. I'll be back tomorrow. But in the meantime, the Dow's up 124, and the MACD is good. There's no question about it, but it's not as good as it was, and the stochastic's fabulous at 90%. It's just the on-balance volume is giving a hint that if there is a pullback in the next 2 days, watch the 30,850 area. A close under that says, hey, this could last a little longer. So far, so good. I'll be back tomorrow. Have a wonderful day. And stay tuned for great programming here at TFNN. Check out my opening format, baby.